Hello students, welcome back. Today we are going to start with our first topic in English language. This video is for the 7th standard students. Our topic for today is notice and email. So for now we will focus on notice. We will study how to write notice, the format and certain things that you need to keep in mind while writing notice. Now, when you're writing a notice, notice is basically a way to intimidate people, especially for school children, about something that is happening in school or something that is being organized. So you have to express it in limited words. It should not be exaggerated. It should be very, very precise. You need to give a very creative title so that people get attracted towards it, their attention is captured, and it has to be relevant to the event that is happening. Now you have to draft the notice in such a way that it is prior to the event of about 10 to 14 days. There is no need for you to write your telephone number or contact detail in the draft. Name of the sender or the designation is not required. Also, the date of issue of notice is not to be written in the draft. So these are the basic things that you need to know while you're drafting a notice. Prepositions is something that you need to really take care of. You are not supposed to leave lines in between. You have to have a continuous flow, a smooth flow of thought or the details that you are giving in. You have to mention the location of the venue of where the program is to be held. There should be a smooth flow of information and the entire notice has to be brief and very, very clear. So let us look at the format of it. Students, kindly make a note of the format first and then you can copy down the sample that I'm going to give it to you. So this is the format of our notice. First, you have to write the title. Title is basically a name given to that particular competition that is being organized. So if you are having a competition like debate and if you've given it a title like War of Words, then the title will be War of Words. Name of the event, it is an inter-school or inter-class competition. Then date has to be of the day when the competition is going to be held. You are not supposed to write the date of when you are drafting the notice, but you write the date of the day when you are going to have the competition. Time, you have to give proper time, mention proper time in the draft and the venue of where the program is to be held. Also, you have to give participation and registration details. This has to come all in the center of the page. It should not be on the right hand side, neither on the left hand side. It has to be in the center, one after the other, without leaving line. So here is an example for you all. Your school is hosting an inter-school debate competition. Write a notice for your school informing them of the event. So this is a question and you have to draft a notice on this. So I have given you all this as a sample for you to understand how to draft a notice. I will be giving you another question to solve wherein you have to solve it and send it back to me and I will correct it for you. So let's go back. This is a sample. So you have given a title, War of Words. Then is the name of the event, that is inter-school debate competition. Now you must have noticed that in this too, we have capitalized the initial letter and it is not in a sentence form but in a phrase. So you have to be very careful of these two things, that is, your title has to be between 3 to 4 words, not a sentence. It should be a phrase, and your the name of the event that you are giving here, the nature of the event, what is the event like, has to be in a phrase form. You cannot put it in a sentence form. Then your date. Now you have to be careful about the preposition. You have to write on 8th July 2020. So you have to write it in that particular way. It should not be in numbers, but it has to be in this manner, 8th July 2020. Again, you have to write the time in this format, that is from 9 a.m. to 12 noon. You have to be very clear with the time. Then comes the venue. You have to mention the place where the program is going to be held along with the location, the area. At Centenary Hall, St. Hilda School, Margao, Goa. So you are mentioning the hall, you're mentioning the school, as well as the place or the location where the school and the hall is situated. Then comes your participation and registration details. Now you need to mention whom this program is for. Who are the audience going to be? So you have to be very clear. All the pupils from class 9 and 10 who wish to participate are to give their names to Mrs. T. Baker on or before 1st July 2020. So you need to mention whom the names are supposed to be given to and when. Now if the competition is to be held on 8th of July, you have to give some time for the people who want to register and give them a deadline of when they have to submit the name. So here we have given on or before 1st July. Competition is to be held on 8th, but we have asked them to submit the names on 1st of July. So you need to mention this details, mention all the days, the time and the details that you need to put in there, like who, where, when and what is the nature of the event. So let us go to now the mark distribution. So the title carries 1 mark. You have to be very creative with the title. It carries 1 mark. Name of the event carries 1 mark. Date carries 0.5 mark. Time carries 0.5 mark. Venue with the location, if you put it in a proper manner, it carries 1 mark, 0.5 mark plus 0.5 mark. And participation and registration details carry 1 mark. So this is your format for notice writing. Students, please note down the format that is given along with the sample that is given to you. The next class, we are going to look into how to write email, that is the format, the mark distribution and a sample. So once we're done with the email, I will be giving you all an exercise on notice and email which you need to complete. Thank you very much.